What did you do? Andre Ward made a list of 10 bad habits that fighters have. You own a gym, the Rivas gym in Fresno. What did you tell everybody?
I said, when I saw that on Instagram, I sent that picture to all of my boxers in the gym. I think it should be like the 10 commandments of boxing.
And what feedback did you get?
It's all true.
So anybody stay in your way, don't do alcohol, and don't drink, don't smoke.
The parties will be there after. Don't even worry.
Don't go party.
Parties will always be there.
Don't enjoy the good life and be teachable.
Yes. Always learn.
Does Junior go to your gym?
I've been training my son since he was four.
Four? That's young.
That's how he's got so many fights. He's been fighting since he's been eight.
So. And he's only 14. You want to see him go to the Olympics, win a gold, or do you want to turn pro?
I would like to see him have the whole resume, like a golden boy or like a Ramirez. Keep doing it. We're gonna do it.
Who are your top three pound for pound fighters?
James Toney. I'd have to have Mayweather in there.
Oh yeah.
And Roy Jones.
Why is James Toney number one pound for pound?
For me, just when I was growing up, that was the guy to watch. And pocket fighter, the best fighter I've ever seen inside the pocket.
And the only guy, I'm one of the few guys, not the only, but only 160 to heavyweight win titles.
Yeah.
And did you know that he spent tons and tons, endless hours with James Toney in the
That's
gym?
That's what we were talking about right now.
I used to see them train and spar.
Yeah. That's why he could talk to my boy.
Yep. Exactly. Does he live in Fresno?
I grew up here in North Hollywood, but we moved up to Fresno about 12 years ago.
When he was two. North Hollywood used to be the hood. It come down a lot now.
Yeah,
it's not gangster.
The projects I grew up in, there's apartments there.
Yeah, no, it's here, Lankershim and over there. It used to be back in the day where you would walk there, it would be dangerous. Like, don't walk at night, it's like shooting, stabbing.
Madison Junior High, we used to have drive-bys at our time to run every all the time.
They don't have that anymore. They put the police station there too now.
It's called gentrification.
Yeah, it's Colfax and Burbank.
They're moving everybody out of...
And they go to Lancaster, Palmdale.
Palmdale, yeah.
You're from Palmdale, right?
Palmdale.
Lancaster?
Is it?
Oh, I thought you were up there.
Yeah.
So what are you teaching them right now?
The famous Mexican left hook to the liver.
What's a Mexican left hook? What's a Mexican style? Show us on the back. You're going to learn something new today. Yeah. Mexican left hook.
You know, James is great at this too.
So James Toney had Mexican style?
Yeah, he had all styles.
How do you do it?
So you're touching here, you know, you're side fighting. Then you're touching here, let him see the hook, and then you see it. So you don't have to be hard so it goes away. You just want to just touch.
Hold on, Steven, get up. We're going to use you for example. Yeah. As a human being, because on the back you can't see the other side. So how do you do it?
So here we're going to touch.
You tap him just to get him open.
Yeah.
I've seen Brandon Reels do that and Chavez Jr. do that. Where they kind of distract
Chavez,
you.
Chavez is another one.
So you hit him light on the top. And then they automatically bring their hands up.
Yep.
You learned something new today?
Yes, sir.
Are you going to use it your next fight?
Yes, sir.
Now, in amateurs, you don't see a lot of knockouts. Do you have a few knockouts under your belt?
Yes, sir.
How does it feel to knock someone out?
It's a rush.
Do you have on your phone a knockout you can show us?
I'd have to look at...
Okay, it had
hard. But we just had a fight with another... We had a fight last week with another ranked kid. He's number one in the nation.
Oh, nice.
At 16 years old.
Okay.
Same weight class, but 2 years older.
That makes a big difference.
They're not
big
in
difference.
The same field, but close fight was a good fight. I got video of that. That was a great fight.
That's
that
cool. Look at Danny working. Juan, why don't you give him instructions?
You guys will get better, guys. Get better. Push yourself.
Ooh, look at that.
It's
crazy. When Juan started boxing, he used to come to the gym. And then he took a break for like 12 years. It's true. But your muscle memory from when you're a kid never goes away. There you go, Danny. Jaime, what do you think? Danny has potential?
Yeah, that's fast. Pretty quick.
He's dying right now. Danny, how many rounds did you go? Danny, how many rounds did you go? That's good. That's badass. Three rounds. It felt like each round felt like 30 minutes in there. It's true. What did you think of his sparring?
For us, it felt like, what?
Like
30
minutes? 30
minutes.
Anybody can't get it, baby.
Who do you want to call out?
Oh.
How about Broner or Pacquiao?
I got Pacquiao.
You got Broner?
Pacquiao's fast.
You got Broner?
Broner's done.
Broner's gonna get stopped.
He's done.
Shit, I need to bet everybody. I'm gonna make so much money.
Money.
I'm gonna make so much money.
I bet you money too.
All right.
I bet you $100.
Okay.
For real?
All right, we got it, for real. All
right, look it.
But usually I don't collect, but I might collect this one. Because the Soto Carras, I want to bet here once of like $600, but I didn't collect.
Hey, stop, man.
All right, let's see. What if he doesn't?
Either way, if he doesn't, he's still going to win. Uh-huh. You give him $100, uh-huh. Pay up. I don't know how much you're going to lose. You're probably going to lose a lot.
One, I might not collect because you're my friend, but Broner's going to win. But we'll come back.
You know, because you know. Oh, that's why you don't want to collect, because you know you're going to lose. That's why.
Easy work for Broner. Everybody's writing him off. He's probably be like a 12-1 underdog and he'll beat him. Let me ask, Broner or Pacquiao, who you got?
What?
Broner or Pacquiao?
Pacquiao.
Everybody here, Broner or Pacquiao?
Pacquiao, he'll destroy him.
Broner or Pacquiao?
Pacquiao.
Everybody in the gym got Pacquiao except me.
That's all right.
All right, what should I do with the $100 that I win off Juan after the fight?
What should I do with it?
Use your imagination because it's like you're not gonna win it.
What should I do with it, Elie? You know what? With the $100, I'll buy you a new camera.
All right, stay tuned. Please report that comment. Back reporting.
I'll buy you a new camera.
After Broner wins, I'm gonna have him give you a shout out. I'll split the money with Broner.